A new feature in Photoshop Generative AI is the ability to use a reference image. So I've got some very surprising things to show you on this video, the right and the wrong way to use a reference image. Let's generate a hat. So I'm going to grab the lasso tool, make a selection, and always make sure you put it down low on the head, give it room to actually generate the hat, and then give it space at the top so it doesn't just squash your face. All right, so we're just going to choose generate a fill and type in hat. Right now, we're not using a reference image. We're just doing the old school way. And by the way, I'm using Photoshop Beta, which is where these features are right now. I have another tutorial shows you how to get that. All right, so if you're generating and just using a hat, you might be getting some weird results like this. This is obviously not what we want. Now, if I click on this icon here for reference image, and I can choose an image that I want to work with, here's a picture of a hat. Notice I've isolated the background. It does not work well if you don't do that. Choose open. That icon tells us we now are using a reference image, and let's hit generate. And as you can see, this works a lot better. There's several important things I want to show you, so let's break this down. So you might have a photo of a hat. You may take a photo of an existing hat with your phone, or we could just generate one. So the question is, why not just generate it right here? At this time, I don't recommend creating your reference images inside of Generative Fill because it's the weakest generative AI in Photoshop. Let me demonstrate. We're going to generate our own reference. But before I do, I want to compare Generative Fill to Generate Image, and you're going to notice something very striking. Let's start with Generative Fill. So Control A or Command A will select the entire document. And let's click on Generative Fill. Let's type in 3 fedora hats, isolated background. And we're going to choose Generate. And here we have some hats. It's okay. Now watch the difference in quality Generate Image from Firefly. So we go to the bottom of the toolbar, click on Generate Image, put exactly the same prompt in, choose photo, and generate. And if we look at these results here, you can see they are much better. So since we've already generated this, why don't we use it? So I'm just going to put this to a new document. So let's just right click, and we'll duplicate layer. Under document, set it to new, click OK, and this will create a brand new document containing that layer. All right, so why don't we isolate this hat quickly? So we're going to grab the quick selection tool and just make a selection around this hat. All right, why don't we just copy this to a new layer, Control J, Command J on Mac, and we'll hide the background. Great. This doesn't have to be perfect. We'll use this as our reference. So let's just save it out. So we're going to choose File, Export, Save for Web. We'll call this hat to use, save out the document. Let's just go back to our main image and just clear everything out. All right, so here's our main image. Let's make this selection and generate. So just like normal, we're going to make a selection here that we would generate a hat. Hit generate fill and type in hat. Now this time we're going to go to the reference image, choose image, hat to use, the one we already generated, click OK. And notice the icon, it shows we're using a reference image because that blue check mark that doesn't cost $10 a month. And then we're going to choose generate. All right, and here's some results from using that reference image that we just generated. So hopefully you learned something new in this video. If you did, drop a comment and let me know what you learned. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.